Hey guys! The thing I love to do the most with the Turing machine is to play it live, locking and unlocking a sequence, letting the sounds lead me to unpredictable places. But there is a much more fun way of playing it than just with using the mouse. So in this video I will show you how to play the Turing machine live using your computer keyboard. Let's start! Okay, so first of all let's look at the different inputs of the Turing machine. Let me just zoom in here a bit. Very nice. We have the clock, reset and move trigger inputs, and we have the main CV input. With the main CV input we can control the main knob and lock the sequence, and with using the move input we can move the sequence like pressing this button here. We can move the sequence and add some variation to it. Now if you don't have some sort of MIDI controller, or you have one but you are out of knobs or faders, you can use your computer keyboard for triggering and controlling different parameters within VCV rack, and use the mouse for other things, controlling more than one parameter at once. What we will need is the MIDI trigger module, so let's zoom out a bit again, and we have it here, the MIDI trigger module. In the drop-down menu, you can select the computer keyboard and then the kind of keyboard you have, the device you have. And now we can assign a key. So let's just click on the key you want to assign and then click on the keyboard. And now the key is assigned. And if we look shortly at the scope, I will connect it to the scope into the voltmeter. We can see that this assigned output will output positive 10 volts. You can see it here on the voltmeter and also on the scope, and it will be in a form of a gate, so the longer we hold the key, the longer the gate stays open. Now let's build a small patch so we can see and hear how we can control the Turing machine. So let's add quantum, where are you, set up a scale, C, E flat, F, G, B flat. Let's change also the quantize mode. We will want to add more than one voice, so let's add also the shift register from ML. I will just look for it shortly. Very nice. And add four Bessel oscillators from Volt. Let's put them here. You will see shortly also why. I will just duplicate them. Now I will want to trigger the oscillators using the trigger outputs of the Turing machine, so let's use also four ADSR modules from Bog Audio. Let's make some space for this. One for the first oscillator, another one for the second one, and so on. Very nice. And let's use the quad VCA module from AS, so we have four VCAs in one module, take the level all the way up. And then let's use also a sample and hold module from South Pole, and I will show you also in a second why. Where is South Pole? It's called noise and sample and hold. This one here are four sample and hold modules, again, or sections in one module. Now I'm using a sample and hold module because I want that the change in notes will happen only when the oscillators are triggered. And I will show you how it works also in a second, but let's first send the oscillators to the VCA. So we have already something going here. And the ADSR modules to the VCA CV inputs, the linear CV inputs in this case. Very nice. Now let's change the envelopes also to be nice and snappy, maybe not all the way down here, really quick attack, nice and snappy, and take the sustain all the way down. So we have something a bit more percussive, let's say. Now we will send the CV output of the Turing machine to quantum, then from quantum to the shift register, And we will use also the trigger output of Quantum to trigger the shift register. Let's enable also the cable so we can see what's going on. And from the shift register, we will take four outputs to the four inputs of the sample and hold module. Very nice. And what we will do, or what this will do, it will sample the signal coming from the Turing machine and it will shift it through its eight outputs. This is the shift register. And we will use also four triggers of the Turing machine to trigger the sample and hold. So let's use the first four. One, two, three, four. So again, the shift register will sample the signal coming out of the Turing machine, which is going through Quantum, so it's quantized also, and it will shift it through its eight outputs, and we have four outputs going to the sample and hold, and we have the triggers of the Turing machine, four triggers to trigger the sample and hold, and let's use also the same triggers to trigger also the envelopes or the ADSR modules, and we will use the same triggers for each oscillator. So the first one to the first oscillator and so on. Okay, so now what will happen is that the sample and hold module will sample the signal coming out of the shift register, which is actually our pitch, but it will happen only when it's triggered by the same trigger that's triggering also the ADSR modules. So what we will get is a change in pitch only when the oscillators play and not between the notes. Let's connect shortly the Turing machine to our clock. And I will show you what I mean. We will connect the first oscillator to the mixer. Very nice. So it's being triggered by the Turing machine. And let's send the signal directly from the shift register to its volt per octave input. Not through the sample and hold, but directly from the shift register, it will sound like this. You can hear that the notes are changing also between the triggers. And if you want, this can be totally okay, but for now, let's hear how it is when connecting it through the sample and hold module. So I'll disconnect it from the shift register and take it from the first sample and hold section here. It sounds somewhat cleaner maybe, and again it's not a must, but and you know what, let's listen to it again through the shift register so you can hear the difference. They are like note tails changing even though the oscillator is not being triggered. And let's listen to it one more time through the sample and hold module. So let's leave it like this for now, and let's connect also all the other ones to the sample and hold module, again to the volt per octave inputs of the oscillators. And let's connect them also to the mixer. Very nice. Now let's lower the octave of the second oscillator. Yeah, and raise the one of the last oscillator, the fourth. Very nice. So we have some chords playing. But let's add also some movement in the sound and use for this another shift register. So let's duplicate this here and use the signal coming out from the second output of the Turing machine, the volts output. Let's trigger it also from Quantum and send those signals to all eight inputs of the oscillators, the modulation inputs. We have eight signals for eight inputs. Very nice. Open the attenuators a bit. Already it sounds better, more movement, less dull. Okay, so now we have a sort of a patch we can start playing with, and let's start playing also with the Turing machine. So we will start by modulating the main knob using the CV input. Like we saw before, the output of the MIDI module will output positive 10 volts each time we click the assigned key. And the range of the Turing machine's CV input is from negative 5 to positive 5 volts, which means that if we use the assigned key to control it, we can turn the knob all the way to the right and by that lock the sequence. So let's try this. Let's connect the assigned key to the CV input of the Turing machine, and now we can lock the sequence each time I click this key here. Until I let it go, because like we saw before, it's a sort of a gate. So again, locking the sequence and clicking this key here will be just like turning this knob to the right. Locking the sequence. Okay, so this is already a good start, but what if we want to turn the knob all the way to the left? Like we know already, turning the knob all the way to the left will lock the sequence and double its length also. So for this we will need a dual attenuverter from Befaco, because we will want to invert the signal. So let's add this. And we will need also some sort of mixer to mix the signals. So let's use Unity from the fundamental modules. And now we will assign another key. So let's use Z here. This will be to the left and X is to the right. And let's send this key here to the attenuverter and invert the signal. So we will turn the attenuverter all the way to the left. And let's see this shortly on the scope and on the voltmeter also. So this is again going positive 10 volts. You can see it here. And this here will be negative 10 volts because we inverted the signal. Let's invert it all the way. Negative 10, and you can see it also on the scope. Positive, negative. Very nice. So this will lock the sequence to the left. Let's try this. Let's disconnect this here and connect the one from the attenuverter and lock it to the left. Let's see how it sounds like. Until I let go. Very nice. But we want to be able to use both without disconnecting the one and connecting the other all the time. And for this we have Unity to combine the signals and output them to the same CV input. So let's disconnect it from here and connect it to Unity. So from the attenuverter to Unity, and also the other signal directly to Unity. So now we can lock the sequence in both sides using these two assigned keys. To the right, we have to connect it also, of course, to the Turing machine, to the right, or to the left. Very nice. Now what if we want to turn the knob, but not all the way, so we can lock the sequence but still let some new information through? So let's use another dual attenuverter, again from Befaco. You can use which attenuverter you like. I use the one from Befaco this time. And let's assign two more keys. So let's use S for the left and D for the right. Now let's send both to the attenuverter. We have two channels here. And let's connect the attenuverter to the voltmeter so we can see how much voltage we let go through. Very nice. Now, the Turing machine, the range of the CV input is negative, positive 5 volts. So let's connect, change the voltage coming out of the attenuverter to around between 3 and 4 volts. So let's click the negative one and start turning the knob to the left until we reach, you can see it here, around 3.5. Very nice. And now the positive one will be down here, turn it to the right because we want positive voltage until we reach around again 3.5 volts, a bit more maybe, yeah. Very nice. So now let's see how it works. Let's connect both of them again to Unity. We can use the same channel here and it will go directly to the CV input. And now again, I will press this key here. It will lock the sequence all the way to the right. And this key here, the D key, will lock the sequence to the right, but not all the way. And it will leave some space for new information to come in. Let's try this. Very nice. And of course, you can fine-tune it to exactly how you want it, or even assign more keys for different amount of voltages. And this was locking the sequence. And now let's look at the move input, which will push the sequence left or right. Once more, we will assign two more keys. Let's use a C and V, once to the left and once to the right. And send one directly to Unity. We'll use the second channel here because we need a different input. So I will take to the right positive voltage directly to Unity. The left one, we need negative voltage through the attenuverter to Unity and invert the signal, not offset it, invert it, very nice. Now this will go to the move input and we can play this feature also live. So let's see, let's lock the sequence and start moving it. And of course, because the clock is moving virtually to the right, if we move the sequence to the left, the sequence will just stop. But it's also a nice effect. And we can lock the sequence not all the way and move it. Very nice, so now we can play the Turing machine live. What we can also do about is use the clock input. So let's add another Turing machine. I will duplicate this one and add another quantum. Very nice. And for this voice, we will use the even VCO. And tangents as our filter. Let's add another ADSR module. Very nice. The ADSR module will control the cutoff point of the filter. So let's turn it a bit. Close the cutoff a bit, raise the resonance, open the attenuverter just a bit. Very nice. And let's set a nice long envelope. Long attack, long release, a bit longer decay and sustain level all the way up. Now let's send the main output of the Turing machine to quantum, from quantum to the even VCO. And let's send a sawtooth wave from the even VCO to the low pass input of tangents and to the mixer. Okay, let's lower the cutoff, the octaves a bit. Very nice. Maybe the volume also just a bit. Okay, now let's assign another key. And let's use maybe Q for this one. And this key here, Q, will clock the Turing machine. And it will also trigger the ADSR module to the gate input of the ADSR module. Very nice. So now each time I will click this button, it will change the pitch of the even VCO and also open the cutoff point of tangents. So let's give it a try. And again, it's in the form of a gate. So the longer I press, longer the gate stays open. Let's lower, raise the attack time a bit. Very nice. So now we can lock the sequence of the first Turing machine. This here. And change the pitch of the bass and open its cutoff. Or lock it to the other side, not all the way. Very nice. Okay, so go jam and have fun. That was it. Like always, there will be a link to this patch in the description if you want to take a closer look. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.